Some people leave a mark long after they are gone. Gwen Ifill is one of them. And as of today, her smile can stick to any message you write. I was grateful to be there this morning when my friend, the NewsHour's former co-anchor, was honored with a special postage stamp. The moment was celebrated at her spiritual home. It was an event that drew stamp collectors.
I belong to a stamp club, a black stamp club that collects Afro-American stamps. Because of the honor that she's receiving today, I wanted to come.
And Gwen Ifill fans from far and wide.
The stamp is something that you put on the note to send to your friend. People all over this country are going to be doing that, and they're going to know why I chose the Gwen stamp, because she was thoughtful, she was kind, and she was dedicated to the American public.
The U.S. Postal Service officially unveiled the Gwen Ifill Black Heritage Forever stamp at a dedication ceremony at the Metropolitan AME Church in Washington, D.C. Gwen's brother, Bert, accepted the honor on behalf of the Ifill family and recited a poem he wrote.
It is titled, Gwen Forever. Gwen's smile, her confident smile, compassionate, consoling, cognizant, beams out at us. Posterity has given its stamp of approval. When we have something to say, it's too difficult or complicated to express in a text or over the phone, she will be with us. Our memories, now direct and sharp, will fade over time, just as our lives will. But Gwen's image, legacy, spirit will endure.
Gwen's stamp puts her in the pantheon of other black trailblazers honored with a stamp, including Rosa Parks, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., Ida B. Wells, and Jackie Robinson. Former U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder was a good friend.
Today, more than ever, and in this city at this time and on this day, the need for her is painfully acute. This is a time for journalists to be brave, demanding, unyielding, persistent, and committed to sharing truth with the nation.
Gwen's career in journalism began in newspapers, the Baltimore Sun, the Washington Post, and the New York Times.
Even marginal progress.
She moved to television in 1994 with a stint at NBC News.
They have to find a way to work with this president for the next 2 years.
Then it was on to PBS in 1999, moderating Washington Week in Review.
Gwen Ifill.
Becoming one of the first black women to host a national political program.
And to our new senior correspondent, Gwen Ifill. Welcome, Gwen.
Here at the NewsHour for 17 years, her work took her around the country.
This weekend, the political yin and yang of a crowded field all descended in Iowa at once.
Reporting on politics, sitting down with singing legends.
How do you handle the weight of the divaness of this all? You have a lot of flair.
I love to sing.
Moderating vice presidential debates.
I want to talk to you about AIDS, and not about AIDS in China or Africa, but AIDS right here in this country.
And interviewing heads of state.
The notion that somehow America is in decline is just not borne out by the facts.
But it resonates. It resonates among a lot of aggrieved people who are voting in big numbers for Donald Trump.
In 2016, at the age of 61, Gwen died of cancer, leaving her colleagues and fans devastated. As she rose higher in her career, Gwen mentored many aspiring young journalists, especially women of color. Her pastor, the Reverend William H. Lamar IV, said Gwen believed her connections to African-American communities was essential.
Gwen did not seek, nor did she accept the tantalizing offer to graduate from her blackness. Gwen found gifted black women and opened doors for them that she had to kick down.
During today's ceremony, Gwen's work and values also were recognized by two former presidents, Obama and Clinton. Longtime journalist Michelle Norris was one of her closest friends.
It is fitting that Gwen's image is on a stamp.
and that stamps are the way that we communicate and remain connected with each other. Because Gwen was one of those people that Malcolm Gladwell might call a connector. She loved bringing people together.
Her cousin, Sherilyn Ifill, president of the NAACP Legal Defense and Education Fund, and many others treated the day as a celebration.
Nothing has done more to heal the pain of losing her than those three simple words, Gwen Ifill forever. And at this moment in our country, those words mean so much. For our family, Gwen Ifill forever means that our parents' and our grandparents' struggles were not in vain. They live on in each of us forever.
The Gwen Ifill Black Heritage Stamp went on sale at U.S. post offices nationwide today.
It was a beautiful ceremony today. I was so honored to be there. Gwen lives on inside each one of us at the NewsHour every day. And online, you can find a link to watch the whole ceremony for Gwen. That is on our website, pbs.org/newshour.